The James Webb could change history with the first signs of aliens. Throughout the history of humanity, the need to know where we come from has remained constant in our thoughts. We look at the stars and ask ourselves, will there be anyone outside? So far, we have never found a single indication that life may exist anywhere else in the universe. However, the fact that there is life on Earth is reason enough to believe that there may be life elsewhere. The new James Webb telescope could give us the puzzle piece we need to discover once and for all whether we are alone in the universe or not. Welcome to James Webb's DWARF II, a portable digital telescope. It's intelligent and features the latest innovation in astronomy. From one of the world's leading pioneers of cutting-edge products that break limits, today we bring you the latest innovation, DWARF II, the portable digital telescope that is unlike anything you've ever seen before. Are you an amateur astronomer, birdwatcher, wildlife photographer, or just a photography enthusiast that needs to capture things you can't get close enough to, like a ball game? Well, DWARF II is exactly what you need. Unlike traditional telescopes that are bulky and costly, DWARF II allows you to explore your interests without hassle. For astronomy lovers, automatically track and capture deep sky objects with just one click. Forget about searching the skies for your target galaxy or nebula and having to move within. Our telescope does everything for you. DWARF II's intelligent hardware platform that comes with edge computing capabilities means that you can quickly find your target with powerful dual-angle cameras and intelligently track and shoot moving objects without any manual input. Plus, we have included APIs that allow you to create new gameplay. And for a convenient and enjoyable user experience, DWARF II can be operated wirelessly using your smartphone. Just install the DWARF app and use your phone to focus, rotate the angle, adjust the pitch, switch camera modes, and much more. So whether you need to record that rocket launch, monitor your farm from a distance, or just shoot a panorama, DWARF II is exactly what you need. Back our project today and enjoy 21% off on your DWARF II telescope. The James Webb Telescope. We have made different videos explaining the operation and parts of this telescope in this channel. Still today, we will focus on something much more critical: the discoveries of new exoplanets that could have extraterrestrial life. The James Webb Telescope carries among its instruments a series of equipment that will be responsible for collecting different types of electromagnetic radiation from outer space. Although the James Webb is already where it will remain for more than 10 years, the L2 point, it's not yet ready to operate since it must perfectly calibrate all of its equipment. Correctly position the hexagonal lenses that make up the telescope, do temperature measurement tests of all the devices, and perform some tests of sending data back to the Earth. Something that few know is that the process of sending the collected data to the Earth is one of the tasks that the James Webb Telescope demands the most energy. That is why the most significant possible effort is made to send the most amount of information by spending the least amount of energy. And the only way to achieve that is by sending compressed data packets that are then decompressed here on Earth. It is for this reason that the first images of the James Webb will take more than a half a year to be revealed. The telescope does not send sharp images to the Earth. It sends data packets with a lot of information and a few images that then become high-quality images here on Earth. If the telescope sent images in high definition, its energy would run out very quickly. The L2 point where the James Webb Telescope is located 1.5 million kilometers from the Earth in the opposite direction to the Sun. That is, a signal from the telescope to the Earth takes approximately 3.5 seconds to arrive. A conversation between the control team of the telescope on Earth and the telescope in space has a delay of only 7 seconds, since it is 3.5 seconds for the signal to reach the telescope from the Earth and another 3.5 seconds for the signal to return from the telescope to the Earth. That is how long it takes for signals and information to go from one place to another. As you can see, this is not the reason why the first images of the James Webb Telescope will take time to show. Why they take time is not the signal. What takes longer is to convert that information that comes to us from the James Webb into images that anyone can understand. The first images. For now, there is no exact date of when the first images from the James Webb Telescope will be announced or about what object they will be. The only thing we know is that one of the options could be an exoplanet with a high probability of hosting liquid water and possibly alien life. Exoplanets. In this channel, we have made a lot of videos about exoplanets. We invite you to subscribe so that you don't miss any. Exoplanets orbit a star other than the Sun. They are planets from other solar systems far from our own. Currently, at least 4,000 exoplanets have been found in different solar systems. The exciting thing about this is that as we discover new worlds out there, we realize that most of the planets in the galaxy are very different from those in our solar system. Super Earths and mini Neptunes. There are two types of planets in our solar system: tiny rocky planets and giant gaseous planets. In contrast, the solar systems we have found do not contain these planets. On the contrary, both rocky planets and gas giants are scarce in the universe. Our solar system is very different from most solar systems in the Milky Way. The most common planets in the galaxy are known as super Earths and mini Neptunes. Super Earths are a type of rocky planet with 5 times the mass of the Earth, and the mini Neptunes are gaseous planets much more minor than Neptune, with up to 10 times the mass of the Earth. Those two types of planets would be like intermediate versions between the mini rocky and the gas giants that our solar system has, and in turn are the most common in most solar systems that we have discovered so far. For a long time, scientists and astronomers tasked with hunting exoplanets for extraterrestrial life had focused on searching for planets with Earth-like conditions, a small rocky planet in the habitable zone of its solar system that contains water. Unfortunately, these planets are scarce and difficult to find because they are so small that telescopes cannot detect them unless they transit just in front of their star. Because of this, astronomers began to explore other options. What if planets like Earth were not the only places where life could arise? What if there was a type of planet with conditions even better than those on Earth for living things? Could such a thing exist? The answer is yes, according to the most recent research on organic life signatures. Earth is not the only type of planet where life could arise. Hycean planets. The term Hycean arises from the combination of the words hydrogen and ocean. Hycean planets are up to 2.5 times larger than Earth and boast vast oceans of liquid water beneath hydrogen-rich atmospheres. Hycean worlds are similar in size to super Earths and mini Neptunes, two of the most common types of exoplanets in the galaxy. But Hyceans are different in that they have densities that position them between super Earths and mini Neptunes. Hycean planets are also a diverse batch of exoplanets. Some orbit so close to their stars that they sense a phenomenon called tidal coupling. Tidal coupling. Tidal coupling occurs when the face of a celestial body is permanently pointing to another larger celestial body. For example, this is just what happens to the Moon, our natural satellite. The Moon always has the same face facing the Earth. That is why we always see the same side of the Moon, since the time it takes the Moon to make a turn on its axis is the same time it takes to turn the Earth around. In the case of a planet with tidal coupling, a star on the side that is always pointing to the star, it would always be during the day with scorching heat, while the opposite side would be perpetually in the dark and very cold. If there were a Hycean planet with this feature, the temperature differences between the day side and the night side would be so significant that the water would constantly be evaporating on the side pointing to the star, creating an atmosphere rich in water vapor and hydrogen, while on the night side, the temperature would be so low that everything would remain frozen. Some analyses of various exoplanets and computer simulations have found that the larger radii and higher temperatures that these types of planets present make the biomarkers characteristic of biological organisms more easily detectable in these types of Hycean atmospheres compared to those of rocky exoplanets. Professor of Astrophysics and Exoplanetary Sciences Niku Madhusudan and his colleagues identified several Hycean worlds whose temperatures could be examined by next-generation observatories such as NASA's James Webb Space Telescope. This could lead to a hunt for life where the Hycean planets will be the protagonists. A biosignature detection would transform our understanding of life in the universe, said Madhusudan. We need to be open about where we hope to find life and what form that life might take, as nature continues to surprise us in often unimaginable ways. Best Hycean candidates to find aliens. HAT-P-11b. One of the most promising candidates to find signs of extraterrestrial life is the exoplanet HAT-P-11b. It is the smallest exoplanet known to have water. That P11B is located 120 light-years away in the constellation Cygnus and lies near its star in a 5-day orbit. This world is likely to be too warm for the oceans, but it has water vapor and clear, cloudless skies, which could mean that some effect occurs inside it that evaporates the water and keeps it inside the planet's atmosphere. Kepler-22b. This is the first planet in a confirmed orbit in a star's habitable zone, the region around a star where liquid water can remain on its surface. Kepler-22b is a super-Earth, about 2.4 times the size of Earth. Scientists don't yet know if the planet has a rocky, gaseous, or liquid composition. The world may have clouds in its atmosphere. Kepler-62. This is a solar system with 5 planets orbiting a star 2/3 the size of the Sun and only 1/5 brighter. Kepler-62 hosts 2 worlds in the habitable zone, Kepler-62f and Kepler-62e. Kepler-62f orbits every 267 days and is only 40% larger than Earth, making it one of the smallest exoplanets known in another star's habitable zone. For now, the existence of life on these exoplanets has not yet been confirmed, but the James Webb Space Telescope is expected to help us uncover the mysteries these planets have for us. The advantage of Hycean planets is that being bodies with large bodies of water, they have the possibility of maintaining ideal conditions for life even if they are outside the famous habitable zone. Astronomers agree that a wide variety of exoplanets lie outside the habitable zones and that they could still host liquid water. If we discard these planets from now on, we could be missing a valuable opportunity to find living beings. The Hycean planets have resources and ways to maintain a pleasant temperature within their atmospheres, even if they are very far from the habitable zone. A clear example of this can be seen in our solar system. The aliens could be closer than we think. As we have mentioned so far, the Hycean planets have characteristics that could host living beings even outside the habitable zone. We can appreciate this very well in our solar system when we observe the natural satellites of the gas giants Jupiter or Saturn. These two planets have satellites with large amounts of water. Two of them are Europa, a satellite of Jupiter, or Enceladus, the satellite of Saturn. Both natural satellites have concentrations of water even higher than on Earth. It is highly likely that beneath the miles of ice on the surface of these natural satellites are oceans of liquid water with aquatic living beings. If we find extraterrestrials on any of these natural satellites one day, the chances of finding living things on exoplanets with similar characteristics will increase dramatically. For now, the James Webb is still in calibration, but in a few months, it will give us the most impressive images of the universe, and perhaps it will finally be revealed once and for all if we are alone in the universe or not.